There are some awesome splash pads in and around Houston. Here with a list of her favorites, Amanda Sorena, contributor with the app Mommy Nearest. You guys always have such great resources.
Thank you.
And a lot of these places are free or they're included with your admission price.
Exactly. So I know it's been rainy the past couple of days, but and you have your Game of Thrones interview coming up, but summer is coming.
It's coming.
It's coming. And so here in Houston, one of the things I used to do, especially when my kids were little and not proficient swimmers, is splash pads, because so many of them around the city are free and so many of them are easy to just come in and come out of. So, of course, one of my favorites is Discovery Green.
Oh, yes. Yeah. It's a great one.
It's great. It's got huge fountains, but they kind of come up and down. There's plenty of changing rooms for the kids. Plus, there's a lot of just summer activities there that are, you know, you can tack on to the end. Go do something on one of their Toddler Tuesdays and then go hang out at the splash pad.
Exactly. And remember to bring those shoes. For that, because they're running around, they maybe get into the grass and then the playground area as well. So wear those water shoes.
Exactly, for sure. And then another one that we love going to is Levy Park. So Levy Park got a revamp a couple years ago. So the splash pad component of this park is not huge, but the rest of the park has also a lot of number of features. And they too have a number of free events that happen over the summer. And we're talking movie nights, things like that, reading books, things like that.
You know, in the dog park as well.
It's so great because this can really fill up a gap of time for that age group. Maybe you need something before the nap and you don't need something very long, or you've got a little bit of time to kill. Splash pads really are the great way, and those two locations, Discovery Green and Levy Park, can you can meet friends. It's very easy.
It's very easy. And then also the Houston Zoo has a splash pad.
We
always forget, you know, there's so many things to see at the zoo, but you can also go there, bring a change of clothes, bring some food, hang out at the zoo. And theirs is actually eco-friendly, which we would expect at the zoo. It doesn't get activated until those kids touch those water activities.
And look at that colorful sea serpent there. It's unbelievable. This place is huge. 13,500 square foot Catherine McGovern Water Play Park. Yes. That's huge.
It's huge. And they also have changing rooms and all of those great things too. So you can just throw in the swimsuit and the swim diapers or whatever you need to in the bag, go see the park, bring some food, make the whole day at the zoo as well.
And head out to Constellation Field, because this is also a really great spot at the Skeeters where they
and
play.
And this is another secret, I think. People don't know. I mean, we have the Astros, love rooting for the Astros, but we also have the Sugarland Skeeters. And they have a playground and a splash pad in the ball field. So when you've got your ticket to go see them play, you can also head out just outside of center field, and you can keep the kids occupied out there too and still watch the game a little bit from there as well.
Oh my gosh, that looks like so much fun. Another great free option is Irvin Chu Park?
Yes. So one of the things I love about Irvin Chu Park is it's one of the year-round splash pads. So, you know, say all of these other seasonal things close and it's still hot and it's September, all you have to do there is go and you push the button and the splash pad gets activated.
Oh, awesome.
Which is great because you know that it will not be over just when September hits.
And you say, be warned though, the only bathroom there is a porta potty?
It is a porta potty. So that is not one we spend the whole day at, but it is one that we might go in the morning, have a morning snack, and then head out.
Oh, porta potty's not that bad. Reminds me of home.
All right, let's tackle some beaches because you have some great ideas there.
Yes.
Too.
And so if you go to the Mommy Nearest site, there's also a whole list of six different beaches that are not Galveston, because there are other beaches. Galveston's great, don't get me wrong, but sometimes you want to try something a little bit different.
Sure.
And I always forget we're really only an hour away from being at the beach. Like, we're willing to drive when we're on vacation. Why aren't we willing to drive when we're here in Houston? Surfside is one of my favorites because you can drive your car onto the beach. So you're not lugging all of your beach gear. All you're doing is packing it once, and then you can just pull what you need out of the car while you're there.
Plus, you can swing by and grab a daiquiri to go.
There is a little Surfin' Rita's has some daiquiris and snow cones. You know, if you don't want the daiquiri.
Family friendly.
Family friendly. There's some snow cones there as well. Another one that's just a little further south than Surfside is Quintana Beach. And that one, actually, if you want to turn into a whole weekend, you can do so. There's camping, RV camping there, as well as grills and picnic tables and things of that nature.
I love this one because besides the restrooms, there's also showers.
Yes, which is helpful once you've gotten all the way down there. Even if you're doing a day trip and you're not spending the whole weekend, it's nice to wash off that sand.
Rinse the sand off.
And even if you don't have an RV, there are some cabins there, too?
There are some cabins. I mean, they book out pretty early, so you got to take a look before you go down there and don't bank on getting them. Right away.
Some great ideas. Let's talk quickly about Mommy Nearest, because you guys really are such a fantastic resource for parents who are looking for resources, finding things to do for the kids?
So Mommy Nurse is a free app as well as a blog, but you can download it on your phone. We're on our phones all the time now anyway. You can pop it up, look at a map, and see what's family-friendly nearby. There's over 70,000 different family-reviewed, people-reviewed sites across all 15 cities that Mommy Nurse is in.
And what's so great, again, 15 cities, but also when you get stuck in a rut and go to the same old places, use that and discover something new because you've got it all there.
And there's so much in Houston. We get in our little pockets and we forget to go to these other places, which is half the fun of being here is to try other stuff.
So many things to do and so great to read all those reviews from other parents. They make a big difference. Amanda, great seeing you.
Thank you. Lovely to see you as always.
And Happy Mother's Day.
You can connect, Mother's Day this Sunday. Connect with Amanda by visiting the Scene on Houston Life section of our website.